You know, moving on to the film that made me a fan of yours, Vivah. You know, I have seen that movie 34 times. I wrote my college thesis on it.
I think even Sooraj Barjatya has not seen it 34 times.
That's a compliment.
If you're a Farah Khan heroine, you will feel like I am the best actor in the world. I'm the best dancer in the world. A Sooraj Barjatya saying, you decide if you want to work with us. Mehuna mein jo ladki thi, she was like the perfect girlfriend material, and Vivah mein thi wo perfect wife material.
Amrita, thank you so much for taking out the time to talk to us today.
I'm happy to do so.
So it's been almost 2 decades in the industry.
Really?
17 years? 16, 17 years.
2002 maybe.
2002, yeah. So it's been a very long and very fruitful journey. You've had some iconic films, some iconic roles. Which to you stands out the most? I think I know the answer, but I want you to tell us.
If you ask me, I would say Welcome to Sajjanpur. Mm-hmm. That's a personal favorite. Because for me, that was a very, very different life, you know, and I had already done films. I was already known. People had a background to me. And then to come across as that village girl with, you know, who was uneducated, who couldn't read. And she went to get her letters read. That was a little fun for me, and I'm sure it was new for the audience.
Right. It was a very special film. What was the experience working with Mr. Benegal like?
Oh my God. I think Mr. Benegal is from my community. You know, we speak Konkani. We're a Chitrapur Saraswat Brahmin.
Yeah.
I've grown up, you know, revering Shyam Benegal. So for me, it was just that a matter of that phone call from him. And I think for the first time, I literally made an exception. I did not even ask what the role is, what the film is. I was like, I am doing your film. So it was a wonderful experience. And of course, you know, Mr. Shyam Benegal is somebody who I believe was truly way ahead of his times. We see directors like Anurag Kashyap explore similar platforms, you know, like the style of filmmaking, it's very real.
Yeah.
It doesn't look scripted,
sure.
You know, there are no commercial songs and dances. He always chose to just move away from the trend and create his own path, which today filmmakers are walking on that path.
Yeah.
You know, so for me, working with Shyam Benegal was actually like working with any contemporary director. There was no difference because he is literally way ahead of his time.
Yeah, that's so interesting. What have been some other iconic roles for you?
Some other iconic roles, Ishq Vishq will always be my favorite, but I think in terms of challenge, it was Vivah for sure. And yeah, even the recent film that I did, Thackeray, that was a very, very different level of challenge for me because there were so many first times in that film, in that entire journey, things that I had never experienced, you know, like aging for a role, spanning from the age of 28 to 60, getting that prosthetic makeup done, you know, trying to come across as the character within that, knowing that it's not a film on Meena Tai and Bala Sahib's personal journey, but it's a political film, but bringing out Meena Tai's character was very interesting for me.
Sure. What about Mehuna?
Mehuna, of course, you know, I mean, when I travel, I do a lot of appearances and events, and I travel to different parts of India. And two films that people actually, you know, like when they see me, it's like either Vivah or it's like Mehuna, and now Thackeray.
Yeah.
So people, I think something about that role of Sanjana in Mehuna has stayed with the audiences. Some of them say that, oh, Mehuna mein jo ladki thi, she was like the perfect girlfriend material, and Vivah mein thi wo perfect wife material. I get that a lot. So I'm like, wow. Okay,
yeah.
Two in one, I'm both.
You know, it's funny, I go to many college functions, and the quintessential college girls dance is always Chale Jaise Hawaye, still to this day. So there's something about that song and something about that role that just...
Of course, you know, I think Farah Khan is one of the most talented choreographers, and I'm so fortunate that I was a part of Chale Jaise Hawaye, and it was a one take song, you know.
That's what makes it so special.
Very special. We rehearsed for nearly maybe 30 days for Chale Jaise Hawaye. First we began rehearsals in the hall, in the rehearsal hall in Juhu. Then when we shot in Darjeeling, we rehearsed for Chale Jaise Hawaye throughout the schedule, and we shot it the last day of the shoot.
Yeah.
So that was, what a memory.
How many takes did it take?
So I think we did it about 4 or 5 times, mm-hmm. that the final day. Mm-hmm. Also because it was, the entire song was shot on the Steadicam, and we had Nitin Rao, who is like the first and one of the best we have. He just came a day before we shot Chale Jaise Hawaye to Darjeeling. So he also was getting, you know, a hang of the song and the choreography, and okay, now she's going to jump on her left or right. So for him also, he had to get a hang of the entire choreography. So we ended up doing it at least, I think, 4 or 5 times. But wow. I think the second take was final, if I'm not wrong, something like that. Yeah.
You know what's interesting about Mehu Nairu was also Farah Khan's first film as a director.
Yes.
So what was that like? You actually saw her discovering her directorial side.
Yes. So I think Farah, when she was there as a director and it was her debut, she was very, very involved in everything. You know, she's a perfectionist. So I remember going to her house, her reading out the script to me. I have memories of her on the day of the shoot, you know, like almost every day of the shoot, she would walk into my van. Okay, well, how's Sanjana looking? How's my Sanjana looking? Okay, then she would take the scissor and say, no, let's just cut this and make a, you know, like those cold shoulders are fashion now.
Right.
I wore them in Mehuna. And, you know, she would actually come and rip my clothes and make me look like that grunge girl, you know. So, yeah, it's all credit to Farah. And also what I like about Farah is that she gives you a lot of creative freedom. It's not like, once she knows that, okay, you come on the set and you know what you're doing and you are in the Sanjana mode, then she will not try and tell you how to do things, which is wonderful.
Sure.
She will, you know, just say, okay, just do what you want to. And she will give you so much of confidence that you feel like if you're a Farah Khan heroine, you will feel like I am the best actor in the world, I'm the best dancer in the world. She makes you feel like that. She gives you that confidence, and automatically when you're in her movie, you are your best.
You know, moving on to the film that made me a fan of yours, Vivah, you know, I have seen that movie 34 times. I wrote my college thesis on it.
I think even Sooraj Barjatya has not seen it 34 times.
Well, that's a compliment. In fact, I remember very well, I assisted Sooraj sir on Prem Ratan Dhan Payo, and when he interviewed me, the first thing I told him is, I said, sir, I've seen Vivah these many times and this is my thesis, please have a read. So I think that convinced him that this guy really wants to shadow me.
I'm sure they must have loved it. The way they operate, they would have loved that kind of,
Why do you think that film is still so relevant today?
Because it is true to the essence of the Indian values and culture. And you know, although I remember when the film released, the English critics wrote the film off. They wrote it off as being a regressive film. They wrote Poonam's character as being regressive and I think out of some fantasy land or something like that. And I remember we were in Kanpur because we were promoting the film.
Sure.
And you know, we were like doing this Delhi, Lucknow, Kanpur, and the film had released, and on the release day we were in Kanpur, and news came that, you know, English critics are writing off the film, and my heart sank, you know, and I felt so sad, and I was like, you know, I'm so like destroyed by those comments. And Suraj ji came to me and he said, you know, Amrita, don't go by these reviews. And you know, he was like, this is just one or two people's opinions. The audience, the bahus, the chachis, the, you know, they will walk in and they will make this film, they will decide the fate of this film. So then his words came true, you know. And then not only that film, but I think after that you had like a series of TV serials that got inspired by the characters of Vivah, and some of them like were almost like copies of exact storylines.
Yeah.
And yeah, that film is truly special. Actually, when I go, like you said, 34 times, you've watched it. Whenever I travel to any part of India, I get that. I've watched Vivah 17 times, 25 times. जब भी आती है हम विवाह देखते ही है एंड इवन टुडे इट्स अ रिकॉर्ड ऑन द चैनल
जी
इट्स अ रिकॉर्ड ऑन द चैनल वेन एवर विवाह इज I mean, it's a weekend and it has to be vivah. So I started finally doing the hashtag weekend vivah.
How did that film happen for you?
Vivah happened to me by destiny. And I think I have been destiny's child. Mm-hmm. You know, like the way I've entered the film industry, it's all as if it was planned. And I think almost everybody's entry, I believe, is destined here. When I remember when Suraji called me for the narration, he called me for a meeting first. Mm-hmm. So we went to the Rajshri office. That was me, my mom, and my manager. Mm-hmm. And we had a meeting. Raj Babu.
I
remember him now, and I can't believe he's no more. But Suraji, Raj Babu, they were a part of that meeting. And it was nothing about the role or the film or the script. It was just trying to understand who I am as a person, you know, and they make you speak in Hindi. They had Prem Chand's book, a novel, and they made me read the back page of it. Mm-hmm. And Raj Babu takes very keen interest in, you know, like these little exams that you have to give. Exactly. So they made me read it, and then they asked me different kind of questions, and I remember that meeting went on for 4 hours. You know, when we walked out, it was night. Like I think it was an afternoon meeting, and when we walked out, we were like, oh my God, this is the longest meeting we've ever had. And my manager said that, you know, I think you're going to bag this role. Then I went to Delhi, and the 26 July floods happened in Mumbai, and the flights were not landing in Mumbai. So I got stuck in Delhi, and then I got a call. I remember I was taking a walk at Lodhi Garden, and Suraji called me, and Suraji said, we want you to be a part of this film. Now you come back, read the script, take a narration, and then you decide if you want to be you want to work with us. That's what he said, and I was like, oh my God, such humility, you know. And I was like, I mean, a Sooraj Barjatya saying you decide if you want to work with us, that is the Rajshri family for you.
So you came back to Mumbai, and then you read the script.
I came back to Mumbai, I got a full-fledged narration from Suraji, and the way Suraji gives a narration with the tape recorder, and you know, like he had the cassette, all the songs of Vivah were already recorded and they were aligned. And then he would give me the narration, and then he would say, now at this point, this song will play, and then we would hear the song. I'd never had a narration like that. And I remember, I think it was the day after that, they had called me to the office again. Or I can't remember whether it was the same day, maybe it was the same day after the narration. Raj Babuji followed me all the way in the, you know, they have a long corridor and closer to the reception, and he said, you know, this role that you have bagged, it's a very difficult role, you know, it's going to be big responsibility on your shoulders. Don't think it's like just a easy, you know, Poonam hai, Mathura ki ladki hai. In my mind, I was like, yeah, don't worry, I will do it. But you know, now I realize what he meant, you know, because I think the role, it was such a mature performance. There was so much to be said without dialogues, so much to be felt and emoted, and you know, I mean, it was a whole roller coaster.
What was the most challenging scene of that movie?
Most challenging scene was the hospital scene.
The one where he puts a sindoor.
Yes, that was very challenging, and that's again Raj Babuji's favorite scene too, because challenging because it was an emotional scene, and again I had no dialogues, I had very limited dialogues. Shahid was doing all the talking, and for me the toughest part was camera angles were changing, and every time you change the camera angle, it takes time, right? So everybody's doing their thing, and you have to still be in that zone, and you know, like you're there and your tear is here, and then again, okay, now cut, now it's going to be top angle, and fir ye angle and wo angle, and you have to remember that, okay,
yeah.
I have to leave, I left it at that pitch, now from this angle I have to do the same thing. So I remember I got so damn irritated You know, it was a little frustrating for me because I was like getting bogged down by the technicalities of this whole function. But then I told myself, dude, nobody's going to see any of these people. They're going to only see you.
That scene was one of his favorites too. I remember once we were shooting the climax of Premrathan and he took me through the whole hospital scene again. Yes. And the entire thing. And he said that when Shahid walks out, do you remember the dialogue? And I said, you know, is pehli baar hospital mein kisi ko dulhan bande dekha. And he was so happy because it was his favorite scene. So, he was very attached to that.
Wow.
Amrita, who were your inspirations growing up as actresses?
Shridevi ji. Completely, you know, like I was that girl who grew up watching Nagina. Like you said, 36 times on loop.
Yeah.
And then there was a part two called Nigahe. So we were like even more excited that, oh my God, more of Nagin and Shridevi ji. So yeah, I was a complete Shridevi fan, like Chalbaz. And I think when I heard the news of her passing away, I can't forget that moment. I just woke up in the morning. I was still on bed and I was just like looking at the phone and it was so surreal and so strange, you know, to see people saying that RIP Shridevi ji. I was like, what?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
And then it took a few seconds to sink in and then oh my God, I actually cried. I think she was the only like personality in the film industry whose demise brought tears to my eyes, because you know, like those childhood bond and that connection when you grow up watching somebody, it's different.
How has the experience been with Thackeray and what sort of response have you been getting?
Well, Thackeray has been such a special journey for me, you know. Firstly, the film walked up to me. I had no clue about this film being made. And what was more overwhelming was that the way they gave me the role, you know. They said that Meena Tai ji had a certain image and you have earned that image and it's only you for the role of Meena Tai. We can't think of any other person. So that was more overwhelming for me. And after I heard the narration and the way, like I said, they offered me the role, I said, okay, this will be different. It's retro. It's that look I have never done. It's aging. It's having like kids in the first scene. So many first times, you know, Marathi, bilingual, shooting in Marathi. It's my Marathi debut. I'm so excited. So many, many, and looking at myself in like on the silver screen in black and white. Oh my God. Like the first times were many.
So what's next, Amrita?
Well, next, again, you know, like I'm, you just saw my schedule today. It's been like narration, one narration after another narration, and now I'm here for this interview. Yeah. So I am taking a lot of narrations and you know, I'm like really impressed by the kind of content people are making now. You know, it was never like this. Mm-hmm. I think cinema has changed so much in the last, last 5-6 years, cinema has just changed. I think the whole method of acting has changed. You know, people are not just acting the part convincingly, they are living the part now. And you can see that. You know, recently when I saw Gully Boy, I was like blown by every single person's performance. Oh God, that's why I say that now actors live their part. They become the soul of the character. And scripts are changing, the way dialogues are not so contrived anymore.
Sure.
You know, the treatment is changing and audience has changed. So that's the best part.
Right. Yeah. But are we ever going to see you in a role like Poonam again?
Well, now if I do the role of Poonam, it would be very different, honestly.
Sure. Sure.
Yeah, I think every, with time you also change. The way you react to the same thing changes. So today, I always think to myself that, you know, if I do a vivah today, like, hey, Poonam would be completely different.
Amrita, thank you so much for taking out the time. Really appreciate it. But before you go, I have something for you to autograph for me.
Wow, this is so beautiful. Like, you've preserved this.
Well, I've watched it many times, so I don't know how preserved the DVD is inside, but the cover is preserved, so. This was before the Netflix and Amazon era. Thank you so much. Excellent. Thank you. Thank you so much, Amrita.